I maintain the wards that protect us from the Crusade siege weapons. They... Wait. Another wizard is fighting me. I must concentrate. I need to... Damn it! Damn!
Oops.
Damn!
Ouch. I should investigate the fort and find the source of the impact. I spoke to the wizard Wine and Hess immediately afterward. A violent impact shook the fort. I must learn what happened. I should return to Khalid and tell him what I've learned. I found Wine and Hess within the walls of Bridgefort. He relays that our troops are small. Most of the people trapped inside the keep are merchants and travelers. We need to coordinate with the Flaming Fist if we're to attack the Crusade with a hope of success. I've already spoken to Jeg Hillcarver. I should return now to Khalid. Oh! Who are these people dead? Kendra, Herdrin, and Lexa. I have no idea who they are.
Huh?
I did not see them here. Oh, I never went up here.
I don't know if there's hope.
I know some say you can't be trusted, but I think you're here to help us. I refuse to believe the rumors.
I don't know if there's hope.
What's going on? You guys hear an explosion?
What do you want?
Push off then. I've got things to do.
We're trapped here.
I wanted to see how my boots were coming. Said it'd take a day. Been a day yet? Yes, it's been at least a day. You can't fool a fool. Tain't been a day yet. If it had been, boots would be done. Boots aren't done. It ain't been a day. Come back when it's been a day, and your boots will be ready. Too far away from you. I'm not trying to use anything.
Hey! Found anything else on my list yet? Getting pretty sick of Adoy running around in my head.
Yeah, I'll tell you. So they ran up here? Dead people! Kendra's body. Oh, I never went back here. So these are people I never got to talk to. That's a shame. A stalwart defender of Bridgefort, Kendra was barely 20 years of age when a spellstone smashed into her, shattering her body and ending her life. Herdrin's defender of Bridgefort, this older man's body has been crushed by a great weight. And Lexa. Beyond a slight indentation on one figure that suggests a ring was taken from it at some point, this elderly woman's corpse is unremarkable. How sad. And Railer is here. Oh, we're going up. That was confusing looking. Here's Wine and Hess and Zari. Zari says, "Someone help Lexa!" I'm afraid she's dead. Are these people dead too? Railer says, "She's beyond our help, son." What's going on here, Hess? You were supposed to protect us from this sort of attack.
And I did. For as long as I could. The Crusade has mages too, you know. I couldn't maintain the red blooding wards. You'd have done no better.
Forgive me. I shouldn't have distracted you. There's nothing to be done about it now. I feel sick? Really? Is there something to be done about the giant glowing rock? Zari says, what's happening? It's the stone, Wynan says. There's an unnatural magical aura surrounding it. Dinah here, can you shed any light on what's going on around here?
This is dark magic. The stone's energy will grow, weakening the strong and striking down the weak. To save all souls in Bridgefort, we need the original Enchanter's spell scroll.
Really? Railer says, you've got to get into the Crusade camp and find that scroll. Without it, Bridgefort will surely fall. I won't allow that to happen. You can count on me to get the scroll. There's no time to waste, Railer says. I can feel the stone's magic moving through my body even as we speak. Go, get the scroll. Save us all.
Find the scroll, and return to me as quickly as you can.
I must enter the Crusader camp and find the scroll used to create this enchanted spellstone. I spoke to the Bridgefort's primary spellcaster, Wynan Hess. Unfortunately, doing so distracted him long enough for the Crusade to launch an attack. Now I must find a spell scroll in the Crusade camp, or Bridgefort will surely fall. The scroll can likely be found with a wizard. Is that one who kept interrupting me when I tried to look in there? In a wagon? The spellstone is here. Okay. I thought it was the stone I was holding. Well, Railer, so talk to him first. Never mind. What about Zari? Guess not. Junia?
You are more than welcome in my sight.
You there! Help me move these bodies, please. Where do you want them? We need to get them to the altar in the next chamber so I can prepare them for burial. Good soul points. I hope their lives in the next world meet better ends than in this one. Let's get them to the altar. Thank you. I should pick up the corpses and move them to the altar in the nearby temple room. Tender of the dead? Junia, a priest of Lathander, has asked me to help her move bodies of the fallen into a chamber for burial preparation. Okay, these people are not dead.
Help us! Please!
I want to fight, not laze around in a bunk all day. Well, let's do lazing around in a bunk.
We can't give up hope.
Greetings, hero. It's good of you to visit us. Alright, let's talk to Wynan.
Why are you still here? You're supposed to be getting the scroll from the Crusaders.
I'll be taking care of that shortly, I assure you. Well, get on with it then. You may have time to chat, but I certainly don't. Be gone. Rather doesn't speak. Okay. Oh, we got this. There's a regular bullets and a regular sling. No thanks. Bridgefort defenders.
We're outnumbered.
Join a caravan, they said. See Faerûn, they said. I'd rather be sailing.
We're outnumbered.
My own brother helps to lay siege to this place. I've tried to speak to him from afar, but his eyes, they look possessed. How could he turn on me like this? Our mother was slain in the last Dragonspear War, but I refuse to believe he would go this far.
We're outnumbered.
I serve the memory of those lost to the Crusade.
Help us! Please!
Oh, my leg.
We can't give up hope.
At least I'm still alive. Better than some.
Help us! Please!
I tried scouting them some of the Crusaders' positions. Got a crossbow bolt in the shoulder for my trouble. Sounds painful.
You want me?
Yeah?
You're slightly injured, aren't you?
Speak.
Yeah.
sweetheart? Yes, dear.
Let's see what's in here. Oh, don't leave. I don't even know where that goes. Exit. Huh. A gold ring and a silver ring. There you go. Oh, she doesn't have a lot of bullets. She's got smaller stacks. Ice. Plus one. And I got plus two. And fire plus one.
Trouble? Sword first!
There's a lot more to this place. Is Frere Tajik and Junia? Okay, just a little more.
How can I aid you?
Well met, and how are you finding our little fort? It's in better shape than I'd have expected, given the Crusade's actions. We have Khalid to thank for that. Without him, we would have fallen long ago. If there's anything I can help you with, please do let me know.
You have my greetings, faithful one.
I thank you for your help. Please place the bodies on the altar. I'll handle things from here. The stone altar's surface has sufficient room for three bodies. Okay. Well, I guess we'll just stay here.
Aye, let's talk more fight!
Mince will grab the bodies. This mural depicts two titanic figures battling on Boroskir Bridge. They must represent the gods Baal and Sirik. Alexa? Are they casting buffs on each other? We have buffs?
What?
They casting energy drain on us?
Fine.
My god protects me and watches us all.
Be at peace.
I need healing. Can you help me with that? Of course. The blessings of Morning Lord be upon you, child. Well, this is a fine how do you do. We don't have any... No, I have level drained. It's weird.
Yes, sword first.
He's encumbered because... Oh wait, he took the body away? Wait, that's not what I meant to do. I thought he was encumbered because of the level drain. Alright, put these bodies in here. Hedrin and Lexa. And then finally, Kendra.
I am here to serve.
You have my thanks. I've exhausted myself bringing all our dead here. A horrible thing to say, but sadly, all too true. Huh. Try this. You obviously recognize the effort this sort of transport takes. I'll leave it to you to determine a fitting payment for my work. I'm afraid I don't have anything to spare. Our resources have been stressed beyond any reasonable limit as it is, which makes me hesitant to do this. I thought she was going to attack us. I must ask one more thing of you. I recognize Kendra here. She's the sister of a guardsman, Tharantis. Could you tell him of her passing? Forgive me, but wouldn't that be something better done by you? I have more survivors to inform. Too many. It would help a great deal if you could speak to Tharantis. He patrols the courtyard. I would be honored to discharge this solemn duty. Thank you again. May the Morning Lord light your way. I should find Tharantis in Bridgefort and tell him of his sister's death. One of the dead soldiers, a woman named Kendra, has a brother serving here in Bridgefort. I agreed to find Tharantis and inform of his sister's death. Okay, so it's sister. Yeah. Did say sister. Their bodies are gone. Just wondering. Three bodies lie on the altar. A band of light skin on the old woman's finger marks the place a ring was once worn. A short sword sheath hangs at the man's side, empty. Well, that's cool. I guess out in the courtyard is this way. Well, what's going on with this level drain, though? Estabar and Mari. Let's talk to them.
Yes. Declare yourself.
Greetings. Happy to have you here. You guard the drawbridge? I like to tell myself that. Though truth be known, I really just keep Mari company. She's the one that's got the last key that makes the bloody thing work. There's only one key? Mari says, yes, I hold the only key. That's the safest way. Half the people hiding in the fort are strangers. Can't trust them. Not a single one. I can see it's in good hands. Look after it, Mari. If the gods favor us, it won't be long before the drawbridge can be lowered again. I hope you're right. So if I talk to her, it'll probably be the same thing. Tell me how to work the bridge mechanism. It should be a matter of putting the key in and turning the wheel, but the bloody thing's so rusted and old, the chain catches as often as not. It's finicky. Okay. That's problematic. Not gonna ask for the key, not yet anyway. You're telling me, but such is the will of the gods, right? What are you going to do? Now, excuse me, I really should be keeping an eye on the enemy and not blathering with you. Good evening. So, yeah, if we had the bridge, and then we lowered it, yeah, that would be leaving them open for invasion. I guess that's an option that we have. Here's Adventurer.
Hello there.
Any new face is a pleasant one around here. Greetings to you, ma'am. Here's Traveler.
Start back, or you'll regret it.
You have nothing to fear with me on watch. Crusader will get our supplies over my dead body. These people are on different levels. I can't talk to them. Here's Tharantis. I'm about a sister.
We're outnumbered.
Something I can do for you? Do you have a sister named Kendra? What kind of mess has she gotten herself into this time? I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but Kendra's been killed. You're saying Kendra's dead? No, you're wrong. It's someone else. Not Kendra. Not my little sister. We were going to see this siege through together. I swore I'd protect her. She laughed and said she'd protect me.
Oh, God.
I know this comes as a shock, but your sister died fighting for what she believed to be right. Honor her memory and do the same. You're right. I'll not dishonor my sister's memory. My heart is broken, but my will is strong. The Crusade will pay for what they've done this evening. Thank you for telling me this. Now, I've a favor to ask you. Kendra wore a gold chain around her neck. May I have it? I helped prepare her body, but I saw no such chain. I'll ask Junia if she found it. Thank you. Please excuse me now. I need some time alone. I should ask Junia in Bridgeford if she found a necklace on one of the bodies. Kendra's brother, Therantis, asked me to bring him a chain she always wore around her neck. I'd better ask Junia if she saw such a thing. Alright, we'll do that shortly.
We're outnumbered.
Yes? Is there something you'd like? You're just kind of staring at me. What's what happens when we talk to people? It goes into, you know, pause mode.
The fair folk rarely have time for small talk.
Read that already. There's a refugee.
Please, help us.
The Crusaders can't take the fort, can they? When I lost the farm, I thought I'd be safe behind these walls, but now... 13 gold, thank you. Alandro and Therim. Therim says, "Forgive us if we're disturbing you, my lady. My young colleague and I sometimes let our passion get the best of us. Better of us." I was gonna read that. "Greetings, I'm Alandro. This is Therim. We were just discussing..." It matters not. "A trivial matter to anyone without a special interest in the arcane arts." I don't know if this is true or not. "No, please continue. It was fascinating. I am Sapphire, by the way." Landro says, "I have neither a potion of invisibility nor a stone of Elnath, so it's all academic anyway, but never mind that. Can you tell us anything about what transpires beyond these walls?" "Kalar's crusade wreaks havoc across the Sword Coast. Coastway crossing is destroyed. Some fear she will do the same to Boroskare Bridge. Our fates are sealed." Therim says, "Please, Alandro, don't start with this again. Think about potions of invisibility and volatile alchemical reactions. Too much fear and despair can summon unwanted creatures, especially at night." "Really? What's the point, Therim? What is the point? I'm on my wit's end. Can't stand anymore. I've not slept a wink in 5 nights. The Crusade will take us and kill us, or worse. We are doomed. Doomed!" "Please try not to agitate, Alandro. Strong emotions can sometimes draw in evil creatures, and we don't need any more threats at the moment." "Since when would anything like that happen?" "I could talk to Alandro and try to calm him down. So what are these people saying?" Therim says, No. "You don't put a stone of Elnath in a potion of invisibility. It just isn't done." Alandra says, "But why isn't it done?" "Because invisible explosions are the worst kind." Okay, I should talk to Alandra and try to calm him down. "I encountered two magicians in Bridgefort's courtyard. They seem to be here by chance more than anything. One mage, Alandro, is terrified of Crusader attacks and death. The other mage, Therim, cautioned me that Alandro's fear could draw in evil creatures, especially if Alandro panics at night. I should keep this in mind." Really? Alright, so we're supposed to talk to him.
"The fair folk rarely have time for small talk."
Eh? What? Oh, forgive me. I'm so scared right now. I thought I knew fear. I thought I could handle it. The Crusade and being trapped in here, in this place. I don't know what to do. I'm supposed to make him feel better about this. That's not gonna help. somewhat, maybe, but, what you're experiencing is not unusual. Acknowledge your fear, accept it, and learn to live with it. This won't destroy you. It's making you stronger. Acknowledge, accept, adapt. I can do this. Thank you. Take care. I've helped Alandro deal with his anxieties. Alandro's fears almost overtook him, but I was able to calm him down. Now that he's gotten a handle on his emotions, any danger is over. I doubt that. We still have danger. I mean, there's people attacking us currently.
What?
But I guess no danger from him. I didn't think something like that was possible.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Here's Killeen. Let's check this other stuff first. A necklace. Worn out boots. Boots are normally handmade by cobblers. Common boots are made by using a form, but good boots are designed for the foot of an individual. Well, maybe the cobbler can do something with that.
We'll do our best.
Be honest. What do you think our chances are? Good? Terrible? I'd say middling. Well, I don't have an option to, ask you. Or answer you, rather. That's opening that. I don't think we should do that. Should we? Let's talk to Khalid first.
My friend, you return.
I've spoken to Hess about our defenders and to Hillcarver about our supplies. What do you think? I need to talk to you about the spellstone poisoning the keep.
What news?
Nothing, I'm afraid. I will depart soon in an effort to find the scroll needed to disable the spellstone. If you cannot, we're doomed. Please make haste. We're counting on you.
My friend, you return.
All right. I guess okay, what if we go through here?
Huh?
Provided one has the key, oops, to unlock the mechanism, this wheel, what in the hell are you doing, Mary says. Nothing, nothing. Not doing anything, me. Get away from there. You'll break the bloody thing. Go, get away. Okay, provided one has the key to unlock the mechanism, this rickety wheel lets whomever turns it lower and raise Bridgefort's drawbridge. Okay, it's not only doors that open, it's a drawbridge that goes down and then these people can invade, and that's not a good idea.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Okay, so
yes.
We need to talk to Junia. See if she knows anything about a necklace.
You have my greetings, Faith.
Have you spoken to Therantis yet? Yes, he took the news of his sister's death as well as can be expected. The Morning Star thanks you. It was a difficult task, but you performed it well. How do you know I performed it well? You weren't there. Oh, I don't know if the other bodies are missing things. Therantis asked me to bring him a chain his sister wore. Do you know where it is? I didn't see anything like that while I was preparing the bodies. It may have been torn off in the chaos. Oh, right, the ring was missing. A short sword, yeah. I figured they were already gone before the explosion. I noticed items missing from the other bodies, too. A ring and a short sword. What are you saying? Someone is robbing the dead? Could be her. I don't know if I want to accuse her right off the bat. It's not uncommon in circumstances such as these. Have you noticed anyone else near the bodies? No. No one here would do such a... Wait. Just before we closed the drawbridge, a man named Imori arrived. He claimed to be a priest of Chanti, if I'm saying that right. He's a quiet sort, keeps to himself, but did good work. I haven't seen him since yesterday. What does this Imori look like? He's human, blonde, on the thin side. About 25 years old, I'd say. Dressed very plainly, with a bit of a beard. Where can I find this Imori? I don't know. I haven't seen him in a day. If he left, he couldn't have crossed the bridge. Perhaps he's in the woods nearby? We can't jump to conclusions here, but I would like to speak to this man. We'll speak again as soon as I learn anything. Once again, you come to my aid. Thank you. I should look for Imori in the woods around Bridgefort. I'm still not ruling her out that she took it. A healer named Imori went missing yesterday. He might have had something to do with the thefts from the dead. He couldn't have crossed the bridge, but he might still be in the woods around Bridgefort. Okay.
Aye.
My god protects me and watches us all.
Back so soon? I suppose Imori is long gone by now. I'm not ready to give up the search. He can't have gone across Boris Gear, and the Crusade would have little to offer. If he escaped the fort, he's likely seek refuge in the woods. Okay.
How can I aid you?
Yes?
Alright, let's return... These people don't speak. Let's talk to Hoach. You've got another boot now.
Help us! Please!
Nothing here. I thought I'd check in regardless, in case you're ahead of schedule for my boot. Well, I'm not. Come see me when I said you should. Okay. Too far away to use that. Teleport circle glows with arcane energy in response to your ward stone. Okay, we gotta find this guy. We gotta find Imori in the woods. Return to Kava the half-orc eventually. I need to find the scroll used to create that. Gotta check on our boots. Looking for ingredients. A feather from a planetar's wing, belladonna, and a turnip juice. I did return to Khalid. And maybe Mazenna's amulet, but that's near the Coalition camp. That's further up. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.